Hi students, so today in this video I am going to explain about Gauss-Jordan method, that is a method for solving linear equations, a system of linear equations given in this model. How to solve the system of linear equations, that is three equations in three variables using this Gauss-Jordan method, that we will discuss in this video. So if you like the video, please subscribe to the channel and share with others. So this is the three equations I am taking basically. You know very well that these equations written in the matrix form is Ax is equal to D. So from this, what is A? Coefficient matrix, X is variable matrix, D is constant matrix. So A and D put together augmented matrix I will take like this. So, in the Gauss-Jordan method, we have to start by taking the augmented matrix. So, by starting from this augmented matrix, we have to apply elementary row transformations and we have to transform this matrix. We have to transform this matrix into the form 1, 0, 0, alpha, 0, 1, 0, beta, 0, 0, 1, gamma. We have to transform the augmented matrix into this model by using elementary row transformations. Only elementary row transformations are allowed. You can't do column transformations here. Why? Because we are finding the solutions. We are solving the equations. And for solving equations, you have to use row transformations only, that is confirmed. So we have to transform the augmented matrix into this model. And you know that this model is nothing but echelon form model. This is called as echelon form model actually. So once you transform into this model, directly by seeing the last column, you can write the solution. So what is the equation formed from first row? 1 into x plus 0 into y plus 0 into z is equal to alpha. So from first row what we get? X is equal to alpha. From second row 0 into x, 1 into y, 0 into z is equal to beta. So y is equal to beta. So once you get this model, directly from first row you get x is equal to alpha. From second row you will get y is equal to beta, from last row you will get z is equal to gamma. This is the unique solution. So this will be called as final matrix, because this is the last step in our process. Once this matrix is obtained, you can write the unique solution like this. So how to transform into this model is what we have to understand. The process of obtaining this matrix is nothing but applying elementary row transformations. Now, one more point. So, while we are trying to transform into this model, we may not always get this model. That means sometimes we may get infinite solutions model. So, if you get like this, you will get unique solution. So, if the given system of equations has infinite solutions or no solutions, you will not get this automatically. So therefore, whenever the given system of equations has infinite solution, you will not get this final matrix. So how you will get that? So when the given system has infinite solution, you will either get all zeros in any one row. I will show you like this. So, you will either get all zeros in one row like this, any row, or you may get two rows identical like this, or you may get two elements of two rows to be in same ratio like this. So, whenever you get all zeros in a row, or two rows identical, or elements of two row in same ratio like this, you will get infinite solutions. So if the system has infinite solutions, you will definitely not get this final matrix. So in between the process only you can find zeros in one row or two rows similar like that. So by that we can identify that the system has infinite solutions. Now when the system has no solution, while we are trying to get this model, if the system has no solution, you will get like this. You will get first three elements zero, last element non-zero. If the system has no solution, so somewhere in between when we are trying to convert into this model, somewhere in between you will get like this. So once you get this, you can stop and write that the system has no solution. Why? Because see here. So from last row, you try to convert this last row into equivalent equation. So from last row, we get like this. 0 into x plus 0 into y plus 0 into z is equal to gamma. We get like this from the last row. Is this possible? If gamma is non-zero, this is not possible. 0 into x, 0 into y, 0 into z. How we get gamma when gamma is non-zero? So if gamma is not zero, this is not possible. Definitely. So therefore, why we are getting an absurd equation or impossible equation like this? Because the system does not have solution, we'll get like that. Okay. So therefore, what we have to remember here is, so when we are trying to get the augmented matrix into this model, if you get this model, from last column, you will write the unique solution. In the process, if you get all zeros in a row, infinite solutions. Once you get all zeros in a row, you can stop and write infinite solutions. You can write the infinite solutions. Already we discussed in the previous videos how to write the infinite solutions. When you have first three elements zero, in the process, when you get first three elements zero, last element non-zero, you can stop the process and write that the system has no solution. When the system has no solution, what you will write? You can't write anything, you can stop there. Okay, so how we have to convert into this model is what is important here. Okay, so we have to use only elementary row transformations. And we have to go step by step. Step by step means first step you have to get the first column in this model. Second step, you have to get the second column in this model. Third step, you have to get the third column in this model. So you have to go step by step. Don't get to try to get the elements in jumbled manner. Don't try to get first zero here, next zero here, next zero here, like that. You have to go in order, then only the process will be easy. So first column, you try to get 100, first step. Second step, you try to get 010 in the second column. Third step, you try to get 001 in the third column.